virtually everyone's campaign literature that I've seen stresses that all the candidates pledge to address problems with education. Can any of the candidates here tonight give us any specifics as to how or what you will do to improve education in troubled schools in the community and assembly district? And you might know, I'm going to say that the BITE committee and the people who are here tonight are, you might have noticed, mainly African American. And that's where a lot of the problem is. Of course, what I call the divide, which is Montgomery Street. We have one school system, north of Montgomery Street, and another one, south of Montgomery Street. So what I'm asking is, please give us any specifics you can as to how you can change that situation.
I am an advocate for the Jersey public schools. The problem that we're having is that the Republicans are attacking us with charter schools to hurt the public schools. I am here to fight for more public school funding. We need that. We need that more than ever. We need to stop the influx of the Republicans trying to ruin the public school system. They are, if you look and see what they're doing with charter schools. Now, some charter schools may be good, and it's an option for parents to send their children there. But they are dividing and hurting the public schools. They don't have any special ed in charter schools. They're taking the kids from the cream of the crop. They're hurting the public schools. We need to stop that. That's how we improve our public schools. By going to do well.
I really think if we want to improve the educational system within this district, it's not just going to take me or any candidate. It's going to take everyone involved. What we really need to do is we need to bring in more money for education, but not just for the schools. What we need is a mentoring system. The reason that children do well in school is because they go home, they do their homework. We need to keep those children in school. We need to have a mentoring system where children can do their homework after school. Teacher is there to help them, and that's how we're really gonna increase the education in that district.
Which we can go here, but just two quick ones. One, funding, all right? New Jersey funded its schools for years under the Head Act districts. A few years ago, Governor Christie cut a deal with the legislature to get rid of out of district funding by creating a funding formula. Since that formula was implemented, it has not been fully funded. And Hudson County loses out each and every year because that formula isn't implemented, to the point where they're back in court and trying to bring back out district funding and bring the district funding. We are losing in Hudson County millions and millions of dollars a year because the formula isn't fully funded, because Governor Christie reneged on his commitment to fully fund the formula. I think the second thing we need to do is we need to support our teachers. Our teachers, especially in Bayonne, New Jersey City, are under a great deal of strain, and a lot of the problems they're trying to deal with in the classroom have very little to do with education and much more to do with society. And I think we need to have that part of the conversation.
State has had control of the Jersey City School District since 1989. That's a problem in itself. You need a legislature that's going to go down there and it's going to unite with Newark and Camden and Madison and tell the state of New Jersey that legislation needs to be passed, that listen, you've had a school district for 30 years, it's time to bring it back to local control completely. That way we can have some accountability with the mayor and us residents having a say. The other thing is this. You can't send employees to work unhappy. There's no way that school teachers should have to wait 2 years to get a contract, to get a fair contract. Those are some of the things that legislation has to be passed. The other thing is, do away with the block testing. If you have to rush to implement it, you know it's the wrong thing to do. You need to get rid of that ASAP. Get on a ride.
Thank you. What education today is the money that's going to these charter schools. I agree with Joe 100%, where they're taking a lot of our funds, your taxpayers' money, my taxpayers' money, and it's going to charter schools. And then they select what students can go into that school. So don't take my hard-earned tax money and give it away to a charter school and then deny my child access to that school. If you realize, most of the people who own these charter schools are pretty rich these days because they're making a lot of money. So it's just a business of them. They don't care about our children, and they're there to fill their pockets. Another thing is these tax evasion. these people, these high-rise buildings downtown, they're not paying taxes, but they are putting their kids in a charter school. So we're getting hit twice. We're getting hit because we don't get their tax money, and we're getting hit because they open charter schools and make all the money for our kids, and our kids are the most suffering. Our education, our kids' education is suffering.
I feel that the parent should have the option to say whether or not they want their child to go to a public school, a private school, home school, charter school, or public school. I have two children. My daughter is in college now. She went to a charter school. My son, he's in a charter school. I am a product of a public school. When I become your state assembly, I will fight for funding to bring back money in Hudson County so that we can have quality education. Also, my nonprofit is Angela Cares, and education is well-rounded. We do financial literacy for kids. We have a six-week program to teach the kids about volunteering. We have programs where we bridge the gap between youth and seniors. We also bring the youth to do poetry. We have family events where the kids and their parents do art together. So I feel when I get down there with Nick, we are going to fight to bring funding, but I feel a parent have an option.
We're here to defend charter schools. I think we all know there's an access education problem, which goes to your last point in the first report. And I also don't think it's productive to divide people and accuse people of trying to undermine the education system. Secondly, to Mr. Chair Velotti's proposal on formula changes, I just want to make it clear for everyone that what he's proposing to do is take money from other children in the state and move it to here. So he's going to take teaching funds out of the hands of the kids in other parts of the state and try to move it here. There's just not enough money to go around. I don't know where you're getting the money from, but there's not enough money to go around. So to talk a solid education problem, I believe that what we need to do very simply is invest in the curriculum and invest in technology, because I'm not sure if everyone knows this, but most of MIT's curriculum is open and available online for free for everyone who wants to go look for it. So what we need to do is tomorrow appoint a task force to start getting all these cloud-based educational materials and bring it into the education system and have a 21st century education policy. And that's going to be the way that we start teaching our kids better, by actually teaching them better. Thank you.
Resolution passed by the Jersey City Council to support Governor Christie and the state, to urge Governor Christie and the state legislature to revamp the state school's funding formula to equalize charter schools' funding. Charter schools presently, as I said, receive 90% of their funding from local school districts. Simon is worried that by making it equitable, by changing the formula to give more money to charter schools, that will have to come from the Jersey City whatever district's budget, it will cause a funding crisis here, because so many charter schools exist here. Already, charter schools get $53 million a year from the city of Jersey City school budget. She's worried that it will triple itself. However, the Jersey City Council voted to approve that resolution. What I have to ask the candidates here is, how do they feel about that resolution? And if it's passed, what will they do when this issue comes up in the State Assembly? Let's start here with Mr. Kopka.
I think it's pretty clear again that moving money around is really not going to solve this problem, because what you're going to do is you're going to end up with, as you're noting, severely underfunded schools. And you can say that charter schools are for the privileged. I don't think the data actually holds that out, but what you're going to have is you're going to have other schools that have no funding, and then other schools that are now underfunded. We're going to get the money to fix those schools. So that's why I'm absolutely convinced that we don't have a spending problem in education. We have an execution problem. We spend more than almost every state in the union per pupil on education. So what we need to do is have people who are able to get in there and revamp the curriculum and actually start holding students accountable. We need to create a culture of high learning. We need to create after-school programs so that people actually focus on education. It's not just a political punching bag for people to accuse each other.
All right, let's count.
The resolution you speak about, all right, so I want to talk more about the charter school issue than the specific resolution. But what I'll say about the charter schools is that I think, as most parents, and I'm the father of three boys, I do want school choice. But the charter school law was passed in 1995, and the idea was that community leaders and parents would come together and create charter schools within their neighborhoods.
When we fast forward 20 years, what we have is the commercialization of charter schools. What we have is that we have international corporations now that have realized that if they can own the building, if they can do the construction, if they can sell, you know, their materials, they can make millions of dollars off of it. And that's what's, I mean, the biggest problem I have with charter schools today is that it's been commercialized. It's no longer, there are some very good charter schools out there that are community-based, but that is not the rule anymore. And we have to revisit that statute.
I just think it's a little bit funny that my opponents are talking about his disdain for charter schools when his running mate is sitting on a board of a charter school. I think there's a place in education for charter schools. The one thing that I'm concerned about is the amount of funding that they get, because they're not held to the same standards as the public schools. And it's easy to say you can send a lot of kids off in your great school, but you get the pick, the cream of the crop. My daughter goes to Marist, and their motto is, go to Marist, go to college. Well, it's very easy to have that model because they're graduating a lot of kids going to college because they're only taking a select few. And that's the problem with charter schools. If they're going to take our money, they need to be held to the same standards as every other school in that district.
Well, I didn't waste the same for charters. What I said was that the law needs to be revisited because they've been commercialized. It's very government.
But let me ask you this, Mr. Your children, at least one of them, are in charter schools. And I understand you're on the board of a charter school. So, as a assembly person, which side would you come down on if there is a side? For more money for the Board of Ed, or more money for charter schools? Because if they equalize the system, more money will still go to the charter schools.
To answer your first question, I'm Angela Lee McKnight, and the resolution that you said that the council has, I will review it, and then I will be able to come back with some decisions. Also, I would like to say that running this city, I'm taking this role serious. I take everything that I do serious. And to come to a forum not informed what questions will be asked so that I can do the proper research is not professional. So as soon as I read this resolution, I will come back with the right answers.
It's up to the candidates to be up to the issues. It's not for me to make to give you the questions and I've never been to a forum yet or been moderating one, but that's true.
As soon as I read the resolution, I will definitely come back and answer your questions. And I look forward to working with Paul. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm totally against it. More money from charter schools. I'm totally against it. You know, we're opening charter schools. Our schools are falling apart. They're taking the money away from our schools to repair them. Downtown at 16th School, it's all crowded. And I think there's plans of getting that property down at Liberty State Park, what they're looking to do, maybe open a charter school there. 37th School is overcrowded. Charter schools, taking that money from the public schools, that money can be spent to repair those charter schools, the public schools. I'm totally against that resolution. We need to stop and fix our public schools first before we go on. One strong point I have here. Most of the charter schools are non-unions. And Vice President, Local 263, we're unions. We, as members, will lose our jobs when more of these charter schools open, and I will not see that happen. I'm against that resolution.
I'm totally against charter schools, ladies and gentlemen. Either you want to go to a private school or you want to go to a public school. If you want to send your kids to a private school, go ahead and spend your money. Or you want to go to a public school and make it better. But don't let them choose, you know, don't let them get rich from our tax money. If you see who are the people who own these charter schools, then go out there and you do your research and you see who owns charter schools. They're doing pretty well. They're doing a lot better than a lot of us. So a resolution to pass this resolution to give more money to the charter school, I'm totally against it. I I didn't think the city council was going to go with this. And I think they should look into it a little bit deeper, because charter schools are not good for us. If this money, if you want to get involved with the public school system, why don't you help settle this contract that teachers need and give them a better place to educate our kids and give our kids a better education.
See, this is the problem. You got people up here who are not informed of the issues. I was at the city council meeting when the resolution was passed. I attend almost all the city council meetings. So you can't tell me that you want to start legislating training if you don't know what's going on in city government. The resolution was passed 7-0 with 2 abstaining. Diane Coleman was one of them. Am I correct, Councilwoman? I believe I am. And it simply says this. Do not let people draw you into the battle of should you fight over. You have to fight over. Charter schools are here to stay. But what you have to understand is this. Charter schools cannot expect the same funding as public schools when they're both public schools and they don't have the same regulation. Period. Everyone knows that. That doesn't take rocket science. But my fellow candidates up here, try going to a council meeting one time before you start trying to run for the state senate.
There is a place for charter schools in education. Okay? They're here to stay. Private schools are here as well. Every parent should have the choice whether or not they want to send their kid to a public school, charter school, or a private school. However, with that being said, some of these charter schools, the lottery process does get circumvented. And you have to know somebody to get in. And these are the practices that need to stop. The charter schools need to be held to the same standards as public schools. That's the only way that I would support 90% of their funding coming from the Board of Education. Until that happens, then we just need to find alternate streams of revenue to fund those schools.
Thank you. The other side, the opposite side, is that it presents a school choice and it gives parents an option if their child is in a school that's just not performing well. How do you respond to those parents and this issue?
Well, I can do what my opponent Nicholas Chivarato does and send his kids to Staten Island School. I can do that. Or I can go down to Trenton and pass legislation that says, listen, you know what? If a charter school is going to have a lottery, it has to be regulated. The lottery system has to be regulated by an independent person not associated with the charter school to basically oversee the lottery to make sure that it's being done ethically and properly, correct? Or I can do like my opponent and send him away to school. Thank you.
So first, thank you. First of all, I know we're in the desperate last stages of the campaign, but you need to keep my kids out.
No. You leave my kids out because my kids are the ones committing you.
Is there anyone else who has an opinion on this? Dave Wright, Angela, would you like to say something about this?
For these guys, that's what you're gonna get in China. We need to stick to the issues here. Again, there is a choice. If you don't like our public school system, send them to a private school. That's your choice. Let's not use our money to make these other people rich at our kids' expense. Thank you.
Exactly mentioned, charter schools are public schools, and they were started with the best intentions to provide a system of competition and increase the quality of education for children. Now, I think probably a lot of us would agree that since then, there's been a big evolution in education policy, and these things might have been commercialized and privatized too much. The financial incentives are a little messed up, but I think we can introduce some common sense legislation in Trenton to start moving towards parity between public schools and charter schools, because we do need a force for increasing the quality of our education. Things might have gone a bit too far with charter schools.